Today on BRStv, we have episode 15 of the Neptune Apex series, and we're going to go over control type pump in Apex Fusion. Hi, I'm Ryan, host of BRStv, where each week we cover a new topic related to reefing. This week we're going to go over control type pump, also known as the oscillation function from the outlet setup menu in Apex Fusion. There are four basic types of pumps you would instinctively want to use this on. Your return pump, pumps that feed equipment like media reactors or skimmers, power heads, and dosing pumps. It starts off pretty simple with the fallback option, which is the state you want the outlet to be in if it ever gets disconnected from the Apex base unit. Most flow and return pumps, you'll probably want to set this to on. I'd wager most equipment feed pumps as well. However, dosing pumps, you'll likely want the fallback option set to off. The next option is the initial off time, then on time, then off time. If you're like most other people on the planet, you're probably saying, what the hell does that mean and why is it relevant to my return pump or equipment feed pumps? Answer is, it's really not that relevant to return or equipment pumps. It's designed more for oscillating pumps like one you'd find on a wave maker. Hopefully sometime in the future, they'll make an additional control type for return or equipment pumps to make it a bit clearer. However, you can still use this function for these if you want. Just set the initial off time to zero, the on time to basically anything, I'll use 10 minutes, and the off time to zero. To try and make sense of all this, it means the pump will come on immediately, stay on for 10 minutes, and then never turn off. Another option for the return and equipment feed pumps is to not select the pump option and select advanced instead. Within the advanced field, write fallback on in the first line and set on in the second line. This will make sure the return or media reactor pump stays on if it gets disconnected from the base unit, and the set line will just tell the outlet to always be on when it is connected. Some of you may want to turn off one or more of these pumps when you feed. All you need to do is add a line that says, if feed A000, then off, which will turn off a pump when feed mode A is triggered. Okay, time to discuss what this pump or oscillating function is really used for. I'll be honest, this is somewhat confusing and one of the more frustrating control types until you really understand how it works. We're going to spell it out completely and hopefully in an understandable language that anyone can get. For this demo, I'm going to connect my Kessel lights to the same outlets as the AC tunes power heads so you can get a more visual representation of what is happening. Let's start with the initial off setting. This is the initial period of time you would want the pump to be off. This initial off period will allow you to stagger the times each pump turns on and create the varied flow patterns for the oscillating or wave maker function we're trying to achieve. For instance, if I enter zero here, the pump will turn on immediately. If I select 5 minutes, it will start the cycle by being off for 5 minutes and then turn on if I have an on time in the next field. There's one component to this that's not obvious and needs to be understood before we can move forward. The initial off time is not from the moment that you hit the send button. What we're doing is creating a cycle that will start at the beginning of the day, which is midnight. Cycle through the three on-off cycles here and repeat itself throughout the entire day. So if I set the initial off time to zero and the on time to basically anything, the pump would behave like it came on this morning at midnight and then stay on forever because there's no off commands. If I set the initial off to 5 minutes and the on time to basically anything, the cycle would start at midnight with the pump off from midnight to 12:05, at which time the pump will turn on. So the on time is how long you want the pump to be on during a cycle, and probably the easiest to understand. If I enter 10 minutes here, when the pump cycle's on, it'll stay on for 10 minutes. Only exception to this is if you enter zero for both the initial off and the off time, the pump will turn on for 10 minutes and stay on forever because there's no off commands. So the next option is the off time, which is the time I want the pump to be off during the cycle. So let's say I wanted the pump to start immediately when the cycle starts at midnight, then turn on for 10 minutes, off for 5 minutes, and continue this cycle for the entire day. I'd enter 0 for the initial off time, 10 for the on time, and 5 for the off time, which would achieve this. The goal of this feature is to have multiple pumps oscillating on and off at different times. So let's set up a pump demo to show you how to set up a simple oscillating wave maker function using two pumps. My goal will be for the right pump to be on for 10 minutes, both pumps be on for 10 minutes, left pump for 10 minutes, and cycle back through right, both, and left all day long. On the right power head, we'll enter 0 for the initial off time, 20 minutes for the on time, and 10 minutes for the off time. This will cycle the pump on for 20 minutes, off for 10, and then repeat. On the left power head, we'll enter 10 minutes in the initial off time, 20 minutes in the on time, and 0 minutes for the off time. This is where a lot of people get lost because it isn't obvious that the initial off time is not only going to be the initial period that the pump is off, but also going to be part of the cycle for the entire day. So the initial off 10, on 20, and zero in the off time result in the desired 10 minutes off, 20 minutes on, and repeat this cycle for the entire day. This is probably the most commonly misunderstood portion of all this, because of the way it's displayed here would imply that a 10 minute initial off time only applies to the start of the initial cycle, when in fact it's part of every cycle, which means if we entered 10 for the initial off, 10 for the off time, what we'd really get is 10 plus 10, which would result in 20 minute off cycles. Okay, so let's get back to proper programming for our right, both, and left oscillating goal, which is right pump configured to initial off 0, on time 20, off time 10, the left pump configured to initial off 10, on time 20, and off time 0. You can watch this time-lapse demo to see exactly how it will work starting at midnight. Hopefully this is all starting to make sense now, so it's time to throw in one more monkey wrench to the whole thing. Since this all works on a 24-hour period starting at midnight, the cycles need to fit into a 24-hour period if you want them to repeat properly. For instance, let's say it was 11:50 p.m. and your 20-minute cycle just started. That means it would end at 12:10 rather than midnight and would push all of your cycles out 10 minutes. The on-off cycles will remain exactly the same length, but the first one will have started slightly later in the day. For most people, this is meaningless, but if you're having trouble getting the right timing or doing something pretty advanced, this is an important piece to know. Luckily, getting the cycles to fit correctly in a 24-hour period is pretty easy. If the on-off cycles are relatively small, just make sure they fit evenly into an hour or 60 minutes. To do that, add up your initial off time, on time, and off time to get a total time for a single cycle. In our case of 20 minutes on, 10 minutes off, the total cycle time is 30 minutes. 30 minutes fits into an hour exactly twice, so we're good. If you're using longer cycle times, you'll need to make sure that the total minutes in a day, which is 1440, is divisible by the cycle time of your oscillating program. So the last type of pump is a dosing pump. While you could dose all of a single solution at once, it's pretty common to use the oscillating feature to break the doses up over the course of the day. For instance, if you had a pump that dosed 1 milliliter a minute and you needed to dose 24 milliliters a day, all you need to do is turn the pump on once an hour for a single minute every hour of the day. Programming for that would be initial off 0, on time would be 1 minute, and off time 59 minutes. This will turn the pump on for 1 minute an hour, all day and night, which will dose 24 milliliters a day with a pump that doses 1 milliliter a minute. Once you upload the new code to your Apex, hit the Advanced Control drop-down and you can check out the oscillation code Apex Fusion wrote for you. If you want, you can add some additional controls like set a time when it starts to dose certain elements like alkalinity at night. You can even add a line which can turn the pump off based on pH to protect the tank. One additional note related to the oscillating or wave maker function in AC powerheads. While today's powerheads are built to stand up to the on-off function better than they used to be, it's still hard on the pump. The way I programmed it was only twice an hour the pump turns on and off, which is still over 17,000 times a year. If you reduced it to 30-second intervals, that's over 1 million times a year the pump turns on and off. You'll burn through pumps and cash doing that, so find a happy medium. CJ makes some nice high-flow powerheads called the Voyager 2, 3, and 4 that use an impeller design rather than a prop, which can start in either direction will last a lot longer on wave makers. They also make a Voyager HP 7 through 10, which uses a prop to move water, but design the pumps and electronics to start in the right direction each time, so it'll also stand up to wave maker functions better than all other AC prop powerheads out there. If you have any questions, advice, or unique advanced code related to pumps, tell us about it in the comments area below. If this is your first time with us, hit that subscribe button because we do this every week. See you next week with another episode of BRStv.